Hello my friends, welcome on this video tutorial. Daniel is here from Tips to Fix, and in this video tutorial today I will show you 10 tips how to protect your YouTube channel, not only YouTube channel but secure your social media or your computer from getting hacked. So continue watching this video tutorial and let's go directly to the point. Okay guys, here we are ready for the tips. Tip number one, you have to be careful from your emails. The first method that will hack your computer, it will take your credentials and everything, email phishing attempts. Let me show you an example now what I'm talking about here. So this email is exactly for phishing, and this one, if you extract it and if you run this 100%, you will get hacked. Okay, this is an email that I received from this Filmora Corporation company. It pretends to be Wondershare or Filmora, okay, but careful, it's not official. It looks like official. The first thing that you have to do when you receive an email for partnership, you have to see here, is this official from Filmora company? Just copy this email address and search in Google, type that question, is this safe? The description here in the email, it looks like official. I mean, link to their website and also link to the about us. And if you click, you will see this is official. I just responded back. They sent me all the details that I will follow up, okay? And it looks a lot of money here, okay, guys? And next, look at this. They sent me contract and my personal link from Google Drive. They are trying a lot to be trusty enough from people. So I have a rare password here. That's a good idea because it will bypass the antivirus. Because if you download it, antivirus can't see inside because antivirus doesn't have the rare password. So this is the reason why hacker put this password on a rare. And look at this now. Click this link. I have advertising cooperation with Wondershare technology. I will download it right now in my computer. Download complete, no problem till here, you see, no antivirus, nothing. So I have a file here. I don't suggest you guys to download it at all, but I'm downloading here to show you what is inside. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to extract it here. And they want me to put the password. Look how tricky it is. I will go to the folder. And you see, the antivirus didn't catch it. Let me do a scan with Cybersecurity here. Scan for virus. One file scan, no threat detection. This one, it looks like PDF, but it's a virus. It's not PDF. Look at the extension now. It's really important to see the extension. I'm able to see here the extension. See, it's a script. If you are not able to see the extension, what it is, you just click here on the menu, options, and then go to view. Here on the view folder options, this one hide extension for non-file types. You see, if you see it like this, then the extension is not show up here. Then this is what you gotta do. Just remove this button here. Hide extension from non-file types and click apply. Then you will click OK. You see MP4 is a video. You see doc file, this one is a script file. And 500 megabyte doesn't make any sense to me. So what I'm going to do, if you install it, then this is the moment that the hacker will download everything from your browser and then they will bypass your passwords and two-factor authentication and everything, and they will get access on your YouTube channel. Don't download this script. Do not run. Do not execute. So I know this is a virus. Delete it. Method number two, session tokens. Why is it important to talk about session tokens? Let's say that you download this email and then you get the virus on the system, but they didn't steal your Facebook account yet, or Instagram account yet, or YouTube account yet, okay? You're lucky. So maybe not yet, but they will steal next days. What session tokens is? Session token is a number that is stored in your cookies and it will keep you logged in on your YouTube account or Facebook or Instagram. And every time that you open up a browser, you don't need to put password again. It means that these session tokens will allow you to log in automatically without putting password every time that you open up the browser. If you get this hijack virus on your computer, they will steal these session tokens for your YouTube channel, for example. They will have access on your YouTube without using any password or two-factor authentication. So they will bypass directly. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to clear my session tokens for YouTube. Let's say we are here on YouTube channel. What you got to do, just three dots here. More tools, developer tools.
Then here on the developer tools, you will see, go to application. If you are here on elements, go to applications here and then go to session storage and see YouTube. And then you will see this number, okay? Creation and YouTube. And then you will see here remote cast available. I have to delete all of these keys. I don't have to have it here. Refresh the page. It will generate some new keys. So if you see carefully, every time that I reload the page, it will generate new key. Session storage and then clear. Another thing that we have to do. Browser extensions. Do not install many browser extensions or install only those browser extensions that you already know. Go to three dots here and then go to settings. You just go here on extensions and see your extensions. Even if you keep it disabled or enabled, I suggest you just delete it. You don't have to have the extensions that you don't know. Another tip that I wanted to explain to you guys. Tip number four. Scan your computer for malware or for viruses with free tools. I highly recommend it is AdwCleaner, that is from Malwarebytes. Free tool is an extra. You don't need to install anything. Here it is, AdwCleaner. This tool is amazing because it will fast scan your computer and it will show you if you have any malware or something. I guarantee you that your computer is already infected with something. This tool here, it's not a virus because it's HP support framework, but for Malwarebytes, AdwCleaner, this is considered as a virus. I will delete it, okay? And as an antivirus, I will suggest you Malwarebytes is the best in the market. Another thing that you got to do, clear cookies and browsing data regularly. How to clear cookies? Here it is. Just go in your browser and in three dots here, settings, privacy and security. You have cookies here or clear cookies. Go back here, clear browsing data or go in advanced tab and then I will clear cookies, only cookies. I want to have those last hour. Okay. And I will clear the data here now. So this is how we clear the cache and cookies from the browser. You have to restart your Google Chrome, reset the settings if you want, and start it from beginning if you suspect that you are infected for any viruses, okay? So next method, six, log out from your account when it's not in use. Go to apps here, you will see Google Apps, Google Account, you will see Security tab here, then you will see here your devices, and see all devices that you are logged in. If you do not recognize something, just click this button and change the password. Another tip that is really important is use strong password and monitor your activity. Log out from your accounts, okay? You have to turn on this two-step verification in the phone. Make sure also manage third-party access. And look at this, I've used Google for all of these websites. I have to delete some of them. I have to remove access from LinkedIn. At the end, be cautious, don't use those public Wi-Fi's to log in on your YouTube or Facebook. The risk to get hacked is very high. Use your own network, use your hotspot from your mobile. So I hope you enjoy this video tutorial for today. If you have any questions or if you get hacked, just write me a comment on the comment area. I will try the best to help you guys. Don't forget to subscribe Tips to Fix for more videos like this. God bless you. See you on the next video tutorial.